Hey guys, it's me, and today I am here with a new reaction video for you guys, and this is going to be part of a bit of a series here on my channel, and that is me reacting to this year's entries for Eurovision. I am super excited about launching this little mini-series type of deal, and I am so excited because already several entries have been announced for this year. As of right now, we have nine official videos for Eurovision, although one of the entries, which we're going to be checking out today, I don't know if it's actually guaranteed that that song is going to be representing that country this year, but we're going to be checking out 6 entries in this video. Yes, we're going to be checking out multiple entries per video, so that way I'm not just having to like crank out like 40 reaction videos over the span of like the next like few months, and it's just Eurovision music. We're gonna do these in bulk because that's how I want to do it. I don't want to react to the national final performances just simply because of the fact that I don't want to get my hopes up, because I got my hopes up so big last year with Albania's song after watching their national final performance, and then the revamp happened. And I was very sad. Not saying that Albania's revamp last year wasn't good, but it could have been so much better. But the songs that we are going to be checking out in this video, I haven't even selected ones that we're going to be checking out in this video, except for one of them. We're going to be checking out 6 because this year there are 41 participating countries in Eurovision. So we're going to be checking out 5 entries per video, except for this one. This one we're going to be checking out 6. Editing here, I just want to let you guys know that as of when I'm editing this video, it's been about a little over a week since I filmed this, so a lot of new things have come out, so you'll see me pop in again in just a little bit, but I do want to mention this little bit of info that came out just today, and that is Belarus might get disqualified this year, so there might be 40 entries? No, 39 entries for Eurovision this year, because they might get disqualified due to their song having a very strong political message, apparently. I haven't checked it out yet, so I don't know if that's what was really going on, but it seems like that's what was going on with it. And then also, a few days ago, Armenia announced that they were pulling out the competition this year. I'm not entirely sure why that's the case. With me and an American living in the States and everything, I don't get a lot of the information up front and everything when a lot of these things happen. So yeah, just want to put that out there. Okay, so the entries that I have selected, we have the song that I'm not sure if it's an official Eurovision song for this year, but according to like things that I've seen online, it is looking like it's going to be an entry this year, and that is Shum by Goa. I can't remember how they say their name, which I was requested to do a reaction video to this song, but I didn't know that this was going to be a Eurovision song because there wasn't any indication that it was going to be one. And then too, the music video is nearly 4.5 minutes long, and the actual song itself is nearly 4 minutes long, and Eurovision songs are typically 3. So I didn't think that this was going to be a Eurovision song, but it's looking like it's going to be. But I've already been listening to the song and I absolutely love it. That's why I'm going to include it in this particular video, because I've already have been listening to the song and loving it a lot. It's so good.
And I am back, so I want to touch on this song. So Shum actually got a different version that they are going to be sending to Eurovision, and this information came out just a couple of days ago as well. So I will be doing a reaction to the new version that they are going to be sending to Eurovision. So that will be like a more legit reaction to the song. But you're still going to see like me react to the original version of the song. But yeah, I just want to let you guys know you'll be seeing the original version that they released sometime back, and then you'll also be getting a reaction to the official Eurovision version of the song probably in the next episode of this little mini series. So yeah, just want to let you guys know about that.
But the other entries that we're going to be checking out, we're going to be checking out Israel's entry, which is Set Me Free by Eden Lenny. I don't know. Remember, kids, I'm an American. We don't learn proper pronunciations of other cultures and countries and languages and all that shit. And then we're also going to be checking out Lithuania's entry, which is Discotheque by The Roop. And then Slovenia, which their song is Amen by Anna Solic? Solic? And then we have France's entry, which is Voila by Barbara Pravi. And then we are also going to be checking out the country that I tend to be the most excited for in Eurovision each and every year, and that is Albania, and that is their song Karma by Anxela Persteri. Again, sorry if I'm butchering any of these names. I'm an American. I'm blaming it on my lineage here, because I mean, like, we all know that America's a shit show, so it should work as a excuse. Anyways, these are the six songs that we're going to be checking out in this video. It's going to be a longer reaction video. I'm not entirely sure if we want to have to do jump cut editing to bypass certain copyright laws, so that way I can actually let this be public for everybody to view. Because I know with some copyright laws when it comes to music can wind up getting a video blocked in all countries, which is part of the reason why I'm low-key scared about Spain. Because Spain's copyright laws are very intense. If you've seen any of my Monica Naranjo videos, I always talk about how their copyright laws are intense, because I can't react to any of her official music videos because they get blocked in all countries. But that is it for this intro. We got quite a few songs to get through, and we are running out of good lighting, so we're gonna go ahead and dive on into this. But before we do so, if you guys are new here to my channel, don't forget to hit subscribe, and also while you're down there, definitely give this video a thumbs up, because that'll help me out a lot. All my links are down in the description box below, and yeah, let's do this.
Surprise, back again. I do want to let you guys know that I am going to be doing jump cut editing during the reaction portions of the songs and everything, so the songs are going to be cut up. I will have the full songs linked down in the description box, so that way if you want to hear the full versions of the songs, you can do so. I'm just cutting them up so that way I can hopefully avoid these videos not getting blocked in all countries, but also so that way we are not here for a very, very long period of time, because reacting to 5 3-minute songs in a single reaction video, and I gotta do like my intro, my outro, and talk a little bit about the songs like before and afterwards, we'll be here for a very, very long time with these videos. So yeah, just letting you guys know that real quick.
All right, so like I mentioned earlier, we're gonna start out with Shum by Goa or Goa. I can't remember how they pronounce their name, but we're gonna be checking out this one first because this is the one that I'm already very familiar with. I know when I first started listening to the song, I wasn't 100% on board with it, but as time has gone by, I am obsessed with this song. It's so good. And I love how they brought back like the very like subtle dancing. Except for that one dude. That one dude is getting his entire life. I'm really wondering if this is actually going to be a Eurovision song, and if so, how are they going to edit it to be able to work for Eurovision? Because like I said, Eurovision songs are 3 minutes. I'm very curious as to how things are going to work out. And I love this bit here for some reason, like the dancing in this bit. This is going to be their entry for Eurovision this year, because I know this group is representing Ukraine this year. That was confirmed months ago that they are going to be representing them again this year. But I am just more excited to see if this is going to be the song, because if it is, they are going to light up that stage. And man, this song just takes me back. Like, this bit of the song takes me back to the days when I was really into, like, harsh EBM and agrotech. Next song that we're going to be checking out is Israel's Song, which is Set Me Free by Eden and Lenny. Again, I'm hoping I'm pronouncing the name correctly. I think this was the first official song that got released for Eurovision this year. So let's go ahead and dive on into this.
Take a look what we become. It's been so
she
long.
She looks so good.
Getting you out of my life, I feel so strong. Feeling like a prison, looking for the reason. I don't want to say goodbye.
But think it has a similar vibe to the song that she was going to perform last year. But it's also very different, which I really do enjoy. Yes. I wish Israel would send more songs that incorporate Hebrew into the lyrics. Because I mean, like, one of my favorite Israel entries for Eurovision is Rock Beach Final. That song was raw. Next up, we have Lithuania's song, which is Discotheque by The Roop. I'm really excited for this one because I know their song last year was looking to be a contender for like the top 10, maybe even the top 5, because that song was just so good. Like, this group, they're very like kooky, but in a very fun and artsy way. And I'm really curious if they're gonna bring that with this song. So let's go ahead and dive into it. Yes.
The music flows through my veins. It's taking
over. Ooh, this look.
It's slowly kicking in. Let's disco take right at my home. It is okay to dance.
Oh yes. Got those man heels going. Yes. Still get that kooky artsy flair to it. I'm really digging this bit here. This is definitely a really fun one. I love how subtle the instrumentals are though, but at the same time I wish that they would be just a little bit more punchy. That's just me personally. It's still really good. Okay. That hand choreo though. Kind of like with Shroom, this kind of takes me back to the days when I was really into harsh EBM and aggro tech. Alright, next up we're gonna check out Slovenia's entry, which is Amen by Anna Soklic. Soklic? I'm sorry, I'm not gonna be pronouncing anything correct with any of these. Very, very sorry. So. Yeah, let's go ahead and dive on into this.
Hey child, why you hiding from the light? Why you cowering in fright?
Not really feel on this one. I mean, she's got a good voice, but it's just a little too simple. Like, it has some like good aspects to it, but it's not doing enough for me. Okay. Oh, that's actually on the stage, is it? No. Is it? I can't tell. I'll say this, whenever it comes to Eurovision, I don't want to be taken to church when it comes to Eurovision music. And that's exactly what she's doing over here. That one was a pretty meh for me. I mean, she's got a good voice, but I mean, eh. So next up we have France's entry, which is Voila, and it is by Barbara Pravi.
Écoutez-moi, moi la chanteuse à demi. Parlez de moi, à vos amours, à vos amis.
I love the fact that this is more like a chamber music type song. I really dig that about this. It's not traditional Eurovision type music, which I enjoy. In a way, I kind of wish that there was something a little bit more happening with vocals, but at the same time, I think that if there were, it would take away from the song. I really enjoyed the fact that it's not traditional for Eurovision, at least. And it's very different. You don't get a lot of songs like this coming into Eurovision, which I very much appreciate. My only concern, though, is that I don't think it might do that well in terms of, like, the competition aspect, which is always, like, a thing that I have a strong concern with when it comes to the Big Five, is that, like, I've noticed, like, over the years that I've been paying attention to Eurovision, it just seems as if that sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes some of the entries that the Big Five sends, they just tend to half-ass it sometimes. Not saying that this is the case, this is a really nice song, but I don't know if it's going to perform well because of the fact that it's so untraditional. But it's because of the fact that it's untraditional that I really enjoy it. The
reason why there's not much of the song included is just simply because I was mostly paying attention to the song and the video, so there wasn't a whole lot of commentary. Because I'm trying to keep, like, the bits where I'm giving you guys commentary during the songs to include in this video, so that way it's not, like, very long. And also to, again, help avoid copyright strikes and horribleness and whatnot. So, yeah. So, getting back to it once again.
But I will also say this, though. I do wish that there is something just a little bit more going on with the vocals. But that's just a personal gripe with me. Alright, so now it's time to check out Albania, which I purposely saved for last because, like I mentioned before, they tend to be my favorite, or at least one of my favorites each year. So I'm really looking forward to this. So this is Karma by Oksana Perestiri. Again, not sure if I'm pronouncing things correctly, but let's do this. Ooh. Ooh. Already I am intrigued. And she is gorgeous. I love the hair. Ooh. Yes. Ooh. Ooh, yes. Ooh. I love spaceship, so I love that galaxy bit there. I mean, she is stunning. Absolutely beautiful. And this song is amazing. I'm really loving this video too. Ooh. That's it. Oh, it needs to be longer. Oh, bruh. So, as usual, Albania is proving to be my favorite. And it turns out that this is, like, not only the official version, but it's also the revamped version. And a lot of people were saying that, like, the original was okay, but it felt unfinished, and that this is the revamp. Bruh. Oh, God. I don't want to check out anybody else now because this is my favorite. Oh, I loved this. I loved this a lot. Video was so good. The song was amazing. I just wish the song was longer. Like, it's that good. It's one of those songs where it's just like the song is just too short. Like, this song can easily go on for another 2 minutes. It is so good. So good. But those are six of the entries for Eurovision 2021. What did you guys think of these songs that I checked out today? Let me know in the comments below. Are you guys looking forward to the competition this year? I'm looking forward to it. I am looking forward to Ukraine and Albania right now. They're like my top two as of right now. I mean, there are other entries that have come out so far as well, so I'll have to check them out eventually. Definitely keep your eyes out for this series. I don't know how often these Eurovision reaction videos will be coming out, but like I said, they're all gonna be like group reactions, and after this one, they're only gonna be but 5 songs in each video. So yeah, I'm very excited. I'm very, very excited. I'm so happy that Eurovision season is back. Ooh, I'm so excited. I'm finally listening to the songs as well. Ugh, God. All right, I'm gonna go and listen to Albania's song about 20 more times. And I'll see you guys in my next video, whenever the hell that may be. Goodbye.